Welcome. I'm Astrid Neuenhaus of the Environmental Resources Center at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. I'll be your host for this video series on agroforestry. Agroforestry is a set of practices that incorporates both agriculture and forestry to enhance productivity, profitability, and environmental stewardship. In this video series, we'll teach you tools and techniques that you can use to combine agriculture and forestry on your property or wherever you farm. Today, I'm with Mark Shepherd, farmer and consultant. Hi, Mark.
Hi there.
Mark is a farmer and agroforester consultant for Forest Agriculture Enterprises. Thanks for letting us visit your place, Mark.
Well, thank you for visiting. It's always a pleasure to share agroforestry with people who are interested.
Mark's farm is located in Viola, Wisconsin, in the driftless region of southwest Wisconsin. It's a little hot today. Would you mind if we went to your cidery to discuss more about agroforestry?
Let's go inside. The air conditioner's on.
Sounds good. So here we are in Mark's cidery, where he presses and sells apple cider, hard cider. And it's nice and cool in here. I'd like to talk about cider another time, but right now I'd like to hear about the history of the farm. Mark, has your family always lived on this land?
No, my family hasn't always lived on this land. Actually, my family, I was born and raised in industrial New England, very similar to the suburbs of Milwaukee. It was all plastics factories and heavy industry, that sort of thing. And the farm was purchased by my wife and I and another couple, actually from Milwaukee, back in 1994. And when the farm was first purchased, it was flat lands, which were the tops of the ridges, were in corn stubble. And the remainder of the farm was overgrazed pasture. There wasn't any grass that was taller than you would find in a golf course green.
Wow.
Very heavily compacted. The one patch of woods, maybe about an acre in size, was where all the cattle would go to get out of the sun, and there was no vegetation on the forest floor. It was mud that was about
I bet the erosion was terrible.
And there were huge erosion head cuts all through the main valleys of the farm. And if you can imagine Niagara Falls falling off the edge of the escarpment, and through the years that escarpment keeps breaking back and eroding upstream, that's exactly what these erosion gullies were doing in our main valleys.
So what got you started thinking about agroforestry for this land?
What got us thinking about agroforestry was the fact that we wanted to give an example of a edible woody crops farm where we grew staple food crops on perennial woody crops. Most of our staple foods are wheat, our corn, our rice, our beans, our annual plants that you plant them every single year, and the soil is bare for the majority of the year. We wanted to show a demonstration of how to produce staple food crops on perennial tree crops. Well, that required that we plant these tree crops, and they take 5 to 7 years before they start to produce a crop. And since we didn't have a huge pile of cash at the beginning to start with, we needed to cash flow along the way. So that led us naturally into alley cropping, where we grew our annual row crops between our rows of trees.
Right.
And so that's what led us right into agroforestry.
You're doing lots of interesting things on this farm, and I look forward to learning more about agroforestry with you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.